Let us continue with exercise 2C, polynomial, question number 6. What should we subtract from this polynomial 8 to power of x, 8x to power 4 plus 14x to power 3 minus 2x squared plus 7x minus 8, which behave as dividend? Then the answer we get should be exactly divisible by divisor 4x squared plus 3x minus 2. So that number which we need to be subtracted will be the remainder. So now what to do? We take this dividend, we divide it by divisor. So check the power first. We have 4, 3, 2, all are present. In the divisor also, square, x and 2, all present. Okay. Now here we have 4x squared. Here we have 8. 4 into what number will become 8? 4 into 2. So that means the quotient we have to go 2. Then here we have x squared. Here we have x 4. How many more x we need? We need 2 more. So let us multiply the divisor by 2x squared. 2 into 4 will become 8. X squared into x squared, x 4. Here we have plus sign. We put plus. 2 into 3 will be 6. X squared into x, x 3. Then here we have minus sign. We put minus. 2 into 2, 4x squared. Then we multiply with minus. So plus become minus. Minus become plus. 8 minus 8 become 0. Here 1 plus 1 minus. Look at the new sign, okay? We minus. So 14 minus 6 will be 8. X power 3. Here 1 plus 1 minus. We have to minus. 4 minus 2, 2. 4 is greater. We give with plus sign. Then we bring down 7x. Then again we have 4x squared. Here we have 8. So 4 into what will be 8? Again 4 into 2. Then here we have x2, here we have x power 3. How many more x we need? We need only one more. So this divisor, we will multiply it throughout by 2x. 2 into 4 will be 8. X into x squared, x3. We have sign plus. 2 into 3, 6. X squared. Then we have here sign minus. 2 into 2 will be 4x. We multiply with minus sign. So plus to minus become plus. 8 minus 8, 0. Here 1 is minus. We have to look at the new sign. 1 plus. So 6 minus 2, 4. 6 is greater. We have to put with minus sign. Then both become plus. So 7 plus 4, 11. Then we bring down minus 8. Then now we have here 4. Here also 4. So same. But what happened? Here we have plus, here we have minus. So that means we have to go with minus 1. So minus 1 into 4 will be minus 4 because the power also same, no need to go x anymore. Then minus into plus, minus 1 into 3, 3. Minus to minus become plus. So this, now we into it minus, minus to minus plus, minus to minus plus, minus to plus minus. 4 minus 4 becomes 0. This is plus. 11 plus 3, we get 14x. Then both minus, we have to plus, but sign remains same. So 14x minus 10. So that means the required number which we need to minus in order to get remainder 0 is 14x minus 10. Just to check, you minus 14x minus 10 from the dividend, then again you divide by divisor, we will get the remainder 0. So 4x minus 10 is the 14x minus 10 is the required number which we need to subtract from the dividend so that it will be exactly divisible by divisor. We will move on to the next question. They say here we have polynomial 2x power 4 minus 3x 3 minus 5x squared plus 9x minus 3. So since we have power 4, that means we'll get 4 values for x. Then they give us 2. One is minus root 2. Another is root 2. So we have to find 2 more. Okay. So remember the number of zeros, that means the value of x, will depend on the power of polynomial. Here the highest power is 4. So we will get 4 value for x. But they already give us 2, we need 1 more. Okay, so we can rewrite it this way. Since we have minus root 3 and root 3 are the zeros of px, it means that first value of x is minus root 3, the second value is root 3. This is minus, if I take this side, become plus. So x plus root 3 will be the factor of px. Here plus, if take this side, become minus. They both are the factor of px. So that we don't have to divide them one after another, we can multiply them. If we check here, we have xx, root 3, root 3, same, 1 plus 1 minus. So we can apply the formula, a plus b, a minus b. So it become x square minus b square. So root 3 square, square root and square root and 2 get cancelled, we are left with 2. So x square minus 3, it is also a factor of px because we get this one by multiply both the factors. So now in order to get the other factors, let us divide the polynomial dividend by x square minus 3. So for dividend, we have all the power. But for divisor, we have x square, we jump to 3, which means there must be x. In order to avoid problem, we put x near to x square. But since it is the one we introduce ourselves, let us put with 0 so that there will be no problem. So now let's start with divide. Here we have x square, here we have x 4. So that means we need 2 more x. Here we have 1, here we have 2. So that means we have to go with 2, because 1 into 2, 2. So you multiply the divisor by 2x2 and write it here. 2 into 1, 2. X square into x square will be x4. 2, here we have plus, so put plus. 2 into 0, 0. X square into x will be x3. Plus 2 minus, minus. 2 into 3 will be 6x square. So we multiply with minus. 2 minus 2 becomes 0. Then here both minus, so 3 plus 0 will become 3 with minus sign since 3 is greater. Here 1 plus 1 minus, so 6 minus 5, 1. Because 6 is greater, we put plus sign. Then we bring down plus 9x. So again, here we have no number, so which means there is 1. 1 into what will be 3? 1 into 3. So now we have to multiply the divisor with 3. But here we have minus, so we better take minus 1. Here we have power 2, here power 3, so we need 1 more. So we will multiply the divisor by minus 1x. So minus into plus will become minus. Here we need 3. So 1 into what will be 3? 1 into 3. So we'll multiply with minus 3x. So 3 into 1, 3. X into x square will be x3. Then here we have plus into minus will become minus. 3 into 0, 0. X into x will be x square. Minus into plus minus will become plus. 3 into 3, 9. We are left with x. So then we into with minus. So minus become plus. Plus become minus. So here we have 3, 3. You can cancel. Then this is plus, this is minus, so we can minus, 1 minus 0, remain 1. Then here we have 9x, both 1 plus 1 minus, so we are left with 0. Then we bring down minus 3. Then here we have x square, here also x square, so we can go with 1, it remains same. So here we get now 0, so remainder here is 0. That means the remaining one is this one, okay? So we can write the polynomial as x square minus 3 with this one. This one is the already given. This one we get after we divide. So this one, if I rewrite it again, it become x minus root 3, x plus root 3. Then to get the other two, I have to split middle term with this one. So here, 2 into 1, 2. I have to find two numbers. If multiply, I get 2. Then here, what sign? Plus. If I plus them, they will give us 3. So from where to get the number? From here only. 2, I can multiply it with 1. 2 into 1, 2. So 2 plus 1, 3. So those two numbers which you need to split, they will be 2 and 1. So the first one, you write it as it is. Second one, we can write inside bracket. Okay, plus 1. So minus to plus, minus. Minus to plus, minus. Then here we have 2, 2 common. X, X also 1 common. Then here, we are left with 1x minus. Here we take everything, we are left with 1. Then here we have 1, 1. So again, take common minus 1. It will be x minus 2 plus minus. So this 2, we can take again. Then those. So here we need 2 more number. We can make this one equal to 0. X minus 1 equals 0. Minus, if I take that side, become plus. So x equal to 1. 2x minus 1 equals 0, which means 2x equal to 1, x will be 1 by 2. So the other value for p of x, that means for x, they are 1 and 1 by 2. Okay, 2 already given, minus root 3 plus root 3, and the other 2 are 1 and 1 by 2.